There's a fungus on patrol in the center there. It looks pretty vigilant, so I'd better go around it. Why is it reacting like that? Uh-oh, the fungus on patrol noticed me. There's a fungus on patrol in the center there. It looks pretty... It seems they didn't notice me. It seems that fungus won't be moving for the moment. I should hurry and make my way through. This is the spot. There are several fungi here. I'll hide and wait for the traveler to catch up. This is the one. Understood.
Nahida, what's wrong?
I never knew that it was so tiring to change forms like that. I even used the techniques that it taught me. Seems like its warnings were not unfounded.
The power of time accumulates slowly and goes unnoticed. A great price is to be paid if you wish to perform drastic changes instantly. Thank you for everything you've done. All seems to have gone according to plan. Now, we simply wait for it to wake up.
Apologize. Language is not easy. Need long time.
It's okay, I have good news. Let me explain it to you the fungi way.
Apocalypse ended? Go home now?
Yes. Unfortunately, I've forgotten where home is. I was hoping you still remembered.
Remember.
Really? That's great!
Home, Dendrodragon.
Dendrodragon. Ah, yes! The Dendrodragon! I'm sorry, I just got so excited. I've probably never expressed such emotions before. But yes, our home is the Dendrodragon.
Oh, wait a minute! Paimon's confused! Do you mean the Dendrodragon as in an elemental dragon? Like Dvalin?
Yes, they're both dragons, but Apep, the Dendrodragon, has been around for longer and has accumulated dense elemental power. But I don't quite understand. Why would you say that your homeland is a dragon?
Because we live inside the Dendrodragon.
The Dendrodragon. Inside. Very big. Mountains. Water. Trees. Us.
There is an entire world inside the Dendrodragon's body. The Dendrodragon nurtured the earliest life forms and protected us inside of itself. It once told us in a majestic voice that once we finally matured, we'd be able to start life in a new world. However, that day never came. Our homeland was the greatest place there ever was before the apocalypse arrived.
Paimon's still confused.
Yes, a very good example. It appears that you're much smarter than Paimon. The only difference is that the Dendro Dragon is much, much larger than any Dendro Slime.
Wait, then if that's the case, doesn't that imply that a Pep has also been contaminated by forbidden knowledge?
Yes, that is correct. What has suddenly made you look so worried, Lord of Dendro? I haven't seen this expression on you before.
A Pep is the most adaptable life form in the world. The forbidden knowledge should have become a part of its body a long time ago. Which means that if all the forbidden knowledge has been eliminated,
then a big void will also form inside the dragon!
I'm afraid so. Its body and soul have probably been in terrible shape for some time now. No wonder I haven't seen a Pep for so long. But how did it get contaminated? Was it due to the destruction of King Deshret's civilization? But anyway, a Pep disappeared and has been gone ever since that time. It's been enduring unimaginable pain all the while. It's probably in pain as we speak. Yes! How could I have forgotten? If the Dendro Dragon fails to hang on, the elemental power inside it will no longer be able to maintain its form and will all be dispersed. Dendro elemental power of that concentration will cause the rainforest to overgrow. Giant trees will completely block out the sun. Plants and humans will fight over oxygen. Sumeru will no longer be suitable for sustaining life.
Hey, what about the crystal? Why don't you show it to them and see if they know anything about it?
Yes, I'm sorry. You're right. We don't have time to panic. Have you two ever seen anything like this before?
No.
Its power feels very familiar. Like something from our homeland, but I don't know what it is. I'm sorry our memories aren't very reliable.
It's okay. I'll contact my helpers just as I did before and see if they can locate your other family members. I'm counting on you all. Your info is crucial to us now. Let's wait for their reply again, though I know waiting can feel unbearable at a time like this.
Thank you. Family bringing fruit.
I explained to them that you aren't hostile. After seeing you save it, its family is very grateful to you.
Go home, thief. Hard decision. Don't know. They are weak. I worry. If waiting, then I hope.
Don't worry. I understand what you are trying to say. Family is very important to us, no matter when we were actually family. It has done a lot to protect this territory and can't help but worry now that it's about to leave. Can you do one last thing for it while we wait?
Of course. I can relate to how it's feeling. I need to organize my thoughts as well.
Thank you. Thank you. Tend soil. Food. Don't like plant invasion.
There are two things that it wants you to do. One is to look after the land that the food is grown in, and the other is to drive away the plants that are trying to invade the area.
Soil! There! First! Seed! Here!
Paimon understood that! No need to translate! We'll take care of it right away!
Mm-hmm. Flame Fury.
Quit following me.
Seem like there's too much we can do until we receive some new leads.
Can you tell us about the Dendro Dragon? We don't know anything about it. Who is it? And what does it have to do with King Deshret?
Well, the history of dragons starts from the very beginning of Teyvat. Sumeru was a Pep's territory. In those days, the lush rainforest covered the entire nation.
Oh, so there was no desert back then?
Not at first. That came when a giant spike fell from the sky, turning a huge section of the rainforest into sand. In an attempt to adapt to its new environment, a Pep changed color from the emerald green of the forest to the yellow of the sand.
No wonder those two elemental life forms are always talking about the importance of adapting.
A Pep has always seen itself as the master of Sumeru, and has refused to recognize the new order that was established. Even now, it probably still holds great hostility toward the gods. However, powerless against the power in the sky, and then the forbidden knowledge many millennia later, it's been unable to stir up any trouble. Conflicts between the two sides are destined to continue until a balance can be found. As far as I know, a Pep had been slumbering in the desert, and King Deshret had taken a great interest in it. Maybe this is why a Pep was contaminated. I'm not sure what may have led it to become involved, but rescuing it is definitely our top priority right now. The crystal that I have in my possession is probably the key that links the two matters together.
Importance on appearances, but we do not. We find the experiences, knowledge, and connections we've made to be more important. These are all things that are more reliable than mere external appearances. These are the fruits of time, and the essence of what it means to grow.
Oh, Paimon gets it now! Looks can always change, so what's inside of us is more important. Paimon would still follow you around. Wait, would you not be able to recognize Paimon?
Oh? Understood. Thank you. Still nothing new from the forest. Seems like we won't be able to find your other family members for now. It appears we are out of leads to follow. And if no one knows how this crystal works, then a pet may be in danger.
Sorry.
It's okay. It isn't your fault. I don't think it's a coincidence that neither of you can remember anything about the crystal. Maybe it's because the crystal has a very close connection to forbidden knowledge, which causes memories of it to be unclear. And if that's the case, finding the other fungi still wouldn't help us at all.
The crystal and the apocalypse. The apocalypse and memories. Lord of Dendro, do you still remember the prophecy?
I do. What about it?
The prophecy is a story that connects events of the past and the future. A family member once said that the apocalypse is a part of us, and that there is value in preserving it. The rest of the family did not approve of its opinion at the time, so it left.
Preserving the apocalypse? Do you mean that there's still some that hasn't been eliminated?
That's not very likely. The power of Ermansoul covers every inch of the land. Did the prophecy say where that family member went?
To the limitless depths east of Sumeru. A murky place that no one can return from.
Yeah, that must be the chasm, right? But what is it doing there?
It's impossible to preserve forbidden knowledge, but what if it can be converted to a different form? I'm sorry if I'm suddenly not making any sense. However, I do think it's possible. Follow me. I'll explain it once we find that elemental life form.
So that elemental life form came all the way here on its own and spent a long time by itself? Wouldn't it already have become the Withering like the others?
There is a chance that it could avoid that end, using the power of something here. I'm referring to what was used to fight against the Abyss. It once repaired the rifts of Teyvat long ago. It has the ability to purify and stabilize powers that shouldn't exist in Teyvat. Forbidden knowledge that its light has shone upon is kept here forever in a different form. Yep, it's just like soap bubbles that rise to the water's surface.
Another strange metaphor, but Paimon somehow gets this one.
What the Lord of Dendro means is that the apocalypse was altered by the power of the giant spike and hidden within the oozing filth.
Yes, and it shouldn't be far from here. Let's go and take a look.
Behold!
Time to lose.
Oh, we finally managed to rescue it.
It should be the life form from the prophecy.
That light.
Wait. Something dark is coming out. Something's not right. right! What's going on? Didn't Mahita say it was purified?
Maybe it's because such a long amount of time has passed. Although the power of the oozing filth is more stable than that of the apocalypse, it is still a form of dangerous power. It might have lost its mind after being soaked in it for such a long time.
Oh no! But we still have tons of questions we need to ask!
I should be able to purge it with my elemental power. But this is our only chance.
Traveler!
It's okay. I trust your judgment. I was being a little hasty myself. Let's see if we can think of another way.
Oh, yeah! You said that the elemental power in the crystal was identical to theirs!
You want to use its power, but...
The Lord of Dendro seems hesitant. I, too, would advise caution. It's risky to use its power without fully understanding its intended use.
Don't understand! This no good, that no good. Save lives! Important!
Yes, I understand. But this is our only chance to return home. We cannot afford to be careless.
It's okay, there's no need to argue. I'll think of something to do about the elemental power that will be used.
How about this? Traveler, you could try using it. I understand that you have an amazing resistance to forbidden knowledge.
Don't overdo it, Traveler. Paimon will be worried.
Lord of Dendro, and you others, how long have I been waiting here?
Yay! Looks like it worked!
Lord of Dendro, here in person, does that mean the apocalypse has come to an end? Wait, did you get smaller again?
I'm sorry, that portion of my memory is highly unreliable at the moment. I can't seem to remember who you are.
That sounds about right. After all, the purpose of my existence is precisely for those unreliable memories you speak of. You once said that the apocalypse will be completely eradicated, and that relevant memories will become unstable. Even you couldn't promise that you'd remember our agreement after those events take place. However, you are definitely someone who stays true to your word. My sacrifice is nothing compared to your resolve.
You and I made the agreement?
Yes. You used your power to protect me. That is the reason why I was able to survive here. To be honest, I'm nearing my end. I had thought I'd be stronger than this.
No one can withstand the power of the apocalypse.
In order to preserve a somewhat stable memory, I had to change the power of the apocalypse into a different form. Only the giant spike that fell from the sky was capable of doing something like that. But the moment I chose to go through with it is the moment I lost my chance of being rescued by the Lord of Dendro. But enough about me. Lord of Dendro, let's get to the important matter at hand. As you can see, I won't last much longer.
I understand, and I'm sorry, but... Can you please tell me what this is?
This is a fire seed. It's an essential item for saving the Dendro Dragon. Thankfully, it appears to be in good condition. The Lord of Dendro and our people created this item together. It mimics how the Dendro Dragon's Heart of Oasis operates. The Dendro Dragon has been tormented by the apocalypse for far too long. It too is nearing the end of its power. However, if you are able to reactivate its Heart of Oasis using the Fire Seed, Then the Dendro Dragon will begin to recover. And as a result, our homeland will return to the way it once was.
Oh, so the Heart of Oasis is a pep source of power.
No wonder the crystal was able to heal this fungus just now. That's what it's used for.
What? You used the fire seed to save me?
Mm-hmm. Why? What's wrong?
That's... never mind. It's not your fault. You didn't know. The fire seed contains a high concentration of elemental power inside of it. It's very powerful, yet fragile at the same time. It is not stable in its current form. To prevent any accidents, please don't use it again.
Since I am its creator, I will take responsibility for it. I assure you there's no need to worry.
All right. Aside from being able to heal the Dendro Dragon, the Fire Seed can also resonate with the Heart of Oasis. In other words, you'll be able to find the Dendro Dragon by following the guidance of the Fire Seed. But you should hurry. There is little time to waste.
What about you?
Forget about me. You should hurry home now.
Everyone is returning home, including you.
As I told you, I've already lost my chance to be saved by the Lord of Dendro. Lord of Dendro, I thank you for coming to find me, and for being willing to save the Dendro Dragon. Our past has been saved, and our future has been ensured. It's enough for me, just knowing that they will return home.
Hey! Wait! It turned into oozing filth!
Can you use the Lumen Stone once more? I can still feel its elemental power. Please, of all of us, it deserves the chance to return home the most.
This is a small ball of light that it left behind.
I can feel it. I can feel its knowledge and emotions. It has all returned to its original elemental form and is becoming one with the other family members. Do not be sad, my friends. Its wish has come true, and it's very happy right now.
Because its external form doesn't matter, right?
Yes, because our external form does not matter, and our home has been saved. There is nothing more important than being together with family.
It's not much further. Follow me. We're close now.
Behold!
I can feel its power lingering and shifting around us. Sometimes it feels distant, but other times, it seems close. This is its way of warning us. It has already noticed our presence.
We won't be able to see anything if we keep going that way.